Welcome to the March 21 general session of the Franklin County Board of Commissioners. We'll begin this morning's meeting with the Pledge of Allegiance led by Commissioner Boyce.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
All right. Need a motion for an approval of the minutes.
So move.
Of February 21st, 2017 general session and the minutes of the February 2nd, February 16th briefing session.
So move.
Second.
Moved and second and voting. Commissioner Boyce.
Yes.
Commissioner O'Grady.
Yes.
The minutes have been approved.
Excellent. All right, County Auditor.
Resolution number 175-17. Resolution authorizing an amendment to the contract with Tyler Technologies Incorporated for a computer-assisted mass appraisal system at an increase of $34,950 for a total amount of $34,950.
Good morning, Commissioners.
Good morning.
Morning.
We are here for an amendment regarding a contract with Tyler Technologies for a project consisting of three work efforts. The automation and creation of historical records to eliminate the printing and scanning of our 400,000 property record cards as we begin our informal process for the reval, as well as the value integration enhancements to allow our systems to talk to each other without having to do the data entry that would be required with those 400,000 plus values, as well as the integration of Cyclomedia's geocycloramas, so the street level imagery that we're taking in order to get that to our website so that the public is able to access those as well as our office. Separately from this agreement, we will, as an enticement for the County Auditor's Office, that vendor, Cyclomedia, has agreed to reimburse the Auditor's Office approximately half the cost to offset those costs that we are incurring on this project. Are there any questions regarding this amendment?
Nope. I don't have any questions.
Nope. If there are no, move for passage, excuse me.
Second.
Moved in second and voting. Commissioner Boyce.
Yes.
Commissioner O'Grady.
Yes.
Resolution number 175-17 has been adopted.
Thank you very much.
County Engineer.
Resolution number 176-17. The 2017 resurfacing program for the Franklin County, Ohio declared necessary and hearing fixed for Tuesday, April 18th, 2017 at 9 a.m.
Everybody's healed up.
Yes.
No crutches, no neck braces. Everybody's back to normal. All right.
Good morning, Commissioners. My name is Cornell Robertson, representing County Engineer Dean Ringel.
And I am Carla Marable.
Commissioners, this first resolution is our annual county resurfacing program. It will include 9 sections of roadways totaling 10 miles in 7 townships. This resolution also sets a hearing for April 18th at 9 a.m.
Okay, if there are no comments or questions, move for passage of 176-17.
Second.
Moved in second and voting. Commissioner Boyce.
Yes.
Commissioner O'Grady.
Yes.
Resolution number 176-17 has been adopted. Resolution number 177-17, replacement or rehabilitation of various bridges and structures in Franklin County, Ohio, declared necessary.
Commissioners, this resolution declares 4 bridges necessary for replacement or rehabilitation as recommended by the county engineer. This resolution will allow us to move forward, hire consultants as necessary, and in particular, these 4 bridges are Boer Road over Plum Run North, Sunbury Road over Argyle Woodland Run, Braun Road over Snyder Ditch, and Henderson Road over Slate Run.
Okay. If there are no comments or questions, move for passage 177-17.
Second.
Moved in second and voting. Commissioner Boyce.
Yes.
Commissioner O'Grady.
Yes.
Resolution number 177-17 has been adopted. Resolution number 178-17. Stantec Consulting Services Incorporated, consulting engineers appointed to assist the Franklin County engineer in performing preliminary engineering for the Alum Creek Drive Corridor Study, Franklin County, Ohio, in the amount of $193,680.
Commissioners, as stated, this capital improvement project is in the southeast part of the county, in the village of Obetz and also Hamilton Township. It's along Alum Creek Drive from London Groveport Road north to Groveport Road. As you know, this is a very busy part of our county with Rickenbacker nearby and warehouse developments. This resolution is a consultant contract with Stantec, and we use the qualifications-based selection process.
So what, I'm curious, so they study traffic pattern, flow, density, those kinds of things, and then make various recommendations in terms of improvements, and then we incorporate that into a broader plan or just for that corridor?
Well, for this corridor in particular, they look at all those parameters that you mentioned, and we feel that there's a good chance we'll see a need for another northbound through lane and another southbound through lane, just with the you know, that large volume of heavy truck traffic that's moving along that corridor. Now, they'll also make recommendations on the intersections along that route mm-hmm. as to additional turn lanes that may be needed, whether they're left turn lanes or right turn lanes, that type of thing.
Thanks, Cornell. You know, it's a later point, not now, but later point, I'd love to just learn more about the planning process when we do identify traffic pattern changes that we need, and just the broader thought process around what the planning is. So do we connect it to any commercial planning or residential planning and things like that, other township or village needs? Are we looking at fiber optic burial opportunities or other utility opportunities? So not now, but I'd love to learn more about the thought process around the planning at some point.
That'd be great. So,
sure.
Happy to do that.
If there are no further comments or questions, move for passage of 178-17.
Second.
Moved and seconded. Voting, Commissioner Boyce?
Yes.
Commissioner O'Grady?
Yes.
Resolution number 178-17 has been adopted. Resolution number 179-17. Pannoni Associates Incorporated Consulting Engineers appointed to assist the Franklin County Engineer in providing bridge inspection services on various structures, Franklin County, Ohio, in the amount of $172,897.
Commissioners, Pannoni will help us in particular with two bridges, Lane Avenue Bridge over Olentangy River and Beach Road Bridge over Big Darby. These are our only two cable-stayed bridges, and their inspection is rather specific. Pannoni is a company that can handle that. We did use the qualifications-based selection process, and we've worked with them in the past.
Thank you. If there are no comments or questions, move for passage of 179-17.
Second.
Moved and seconded. Voting, Commissioner Boyce?
Yes.
Commissioner O'Grady?
Yes.
Resolution number 179-17 has been adopted. Resolution number 180-17. Resolution authorizing a contract with True Inspection Services, LLC, consulting for bridge coating inspection services for the Franklin County Engineer in the amount of $60,000.
Commissioners, this resolution authorizes a contract with True Inspection Services for bridge paint inspection. We will be rehabilitating two bridges next year, the Smothers Road Bridge and the Big Run over Big Run Road. And that will require steel beams, that will need to be painted. And that paint is required to be inspected by a certified inspections consultant. True Inspection Services is that consultant. They are on the ODOT pre-qualifications list. We used a professional services contract, and they are an MBE business.
Thank you. If there are no comments or questions, move past 180-17.
Second.
Moved and seconded. Voting, Commissioner Boyce?
Yes.
Commissioner O'Grady?
Yes.
Resolution number 180-17 has been adopted. Resolution number 181-17, plans approved for the multiple bridge repairs project, formerly known as the Bridge and Dam Repair Project, Franklin County, Ohio.
Commissioners, this resolution seeks approval for the plans, specifications, and estimates for the multiple bridge repair project, formerly known as the Bridge End Dam Repair Project. The project will focus on replacing the bridge end dams, which are expansion joints, or the place where the bridge meets the road. And however, as we're out there and we're going to utilize the lane closures, we're going to go ahead and do additional maintenance items, such as repair some bridge decking. These are maintenance items, and they are not structural repairs.
Okay. If there are no comments or questions, move for passage 181-17.
Second.
Moved and seconded. Voting, Commissioner Boyce?
Yes.
Commissioner O'Grady?
Yes.
Resolution number 181-17 has been adopted. Resolution number 182-17, preliminary allocation and final encumbrance of county motor vehicle license tax $5 funds for the City of Gahanna in the amount of $219,000.
The City of Gahanna has requested to use a portion of their county motor vehicle license tax to resurface a portion of Cherry Bottom Road and a complete pavement and to complete pavement repairs on a portion of Morris Road. The county engineer has reviewed these plans and determined that the work is necessary and that these roadways are on the approved list and the work has been approved.
Great. If there are no comments or questions, move for passage of 182-17.
Second.
Moved and seconded in voting. Commissioner Boyce?
Yes.
Commissioner O'Grady?
Yes.
Resolution number 182-17 has been adopted. Resolution number 183-17, preliminary allocation and final encumbrance of county motor vehicle license tax $5 funds for the City of Westerville in the amount of $430,000.
The City of Westerville has also requested to use a portion of their county motor vehicle license tax funds to improve a portion of Cleveland Avenue and resurface a portion of West Main Street and Walnut Street. The county engineer has again reviewed the plans and determined that the work is necessary and adheres to the guidelines for the use of the funds.
Okay, thank you. If there are no comments or questions, move for passage of 183-17.
Second.
Moved and seconded in voting. Commissioner Boyce?
Yes.
Commissioner O'Grady?
Yes.
Resolution number 183-17 has been adopted. Resolution number 184-17, resolution authorizing the county engineer enter into a cooperative agreement with the Central Ohio Transit Authority and the City of Columbus for the Cleveland Avenue Bus Rapid Transit Project.
Commissioners, as stated, this is a cooperative project including Franklin County, City of Columbus, and COTA. COTA plans to expand and improve a 16-mile stretch of Cleveland Avenue from Columbus downtown area to the Polaris area, and this resolution will allow the county engineer to participate in the resurfacing that would be done in the unincorporated areas of that stretch.
Okay. If there are no comments or questions, move for passage of 184-17.
Second.
Moved and seconded in voting. Commissioner Boyce?
Yes.
Commissioner O'Grady?
Yes.
Resolution number 184-17 has been adopted.
Thank you very
much.
Thank you. Thanks, guys. Sheriff's Office.
Resolution number 185-17, resolution authorizing a settlement with Jennifer Gittow for a disputed property damage claim due to an auto accident involving a Franklin County Sheriff's deputy in the amount of $500.
Good morning, Commissioners. Dave Masterson, Director of Administrative Services for Sheriff Dallas Baldwin. This resolution approves a settlement of a vehicle damage claim from an accident that occurred on January 10th, 2017. It's been recommended by the prosecutor and county fleet management and offers payment in the amount of $500 to settle the claim.
There are no comments or questions. Move for passage of 185-17.
Second.
Moved and seconded in voting. Commissioner Boyce?
Yes.
Commissioner O'Grady?
Yes.
Resolution number 185-17 has been adopted. Resolution number 186-17, resolution authorizing a settlement with Mukhtar Muhammad for a disputed property damage claim due to an auto accident involving a Franklin County Sheriff's deputy in the amount of $250.
Commissioners, this resolution also approves the settlement of a claim. This accident occurred on January 12, 2017. It has been recommended by the prosecutor and county fleet management and offers $250 to settle the claim. Any no questions, I ask approval.
All right, there are no further questions or comments. Move for passage of 186-17.
Second.
Moved and seconded in voting. Commissioner Boyce?
Yes.
Commissioner O'Grady?
Yes.
Resolution number 186-17 has been adopted. Resolution number 187-17, resolution authorizing a contract with the Ohio Department of Transportation to continue an inmate work program for litter removal along Franklin County roadways in the amount of $92,500.
Commissioners, this resolution will allow the Sheriff's Office to continue its inmate litter removal program during 2017. ODOT will reimburse the cost of deputy services for inmate security during these duties. Any questions, I ask approval.
Just one quick question. When it says county roads, I mean anything in the county, so it could be in the City of Columbus, in the City of Bexley, or is it more township, village type of
The type of work that they do is typically along the interstate highways, mainly south of Interstate 70 along 71, west of 70, or west on 70 east, or excuse me, 70 west and then 70 east as well. It could be anywhere, but those are typically the areas that ODOT assigns the services.
Okay, thank you. Mm-hmm. If there are no further comments or questions, move for passage of 187-17.
Second.
Moved and seconded voting. Commissioner Boyce?
Yes.
Commissioner O'Grady?
Yes.
Resolution number 187-17 has been adopted.
Thank you.
Thanks, Dave. Child support enforcement.
Resolution number 188-17. Resolution authorizing a 4D contract with the Franklin County Data Center in the amount of $434,357.13.
Good morning, Commissioners. Lori Torriero, Assistant Director of the Franklin County Child Support Enforcement Agency. This is our annual contract with County Data Center. You will start to see reductions now in this contract as this year and the year following, as we are moving from the design and implementation phase of our document imaging system to more of a maintenance mode. But it's been a wonderful project. Thank you for your support. We are on time and on budget, which I don't get to say very often, so I'm saying it as often as I can about this project. Pending any questions, I request your approval.
Good. If there are no further comments or questions, move past 188-17.
Second.
Moved and seconded voting. Commissioner Boyce?
Yes.
Commissioner O'Grady?
Yes.
Resolution number 188-17 has been adopted.
Thank you.
Thanks, Lori. Economic Development and Planning.
Resolution number 189-17, review of petition to annex 0.24 acres from Hamilton Township to the City of Columbus, case number ANX-02-17.
Good morning, Commissioners. Jenny Snapp, Franklin County Economic Development and Planning. This resolution is to consider an expedited Type 2 annexation petition of 0.24 acres from Hamilton Township to the City of Columbus. The area to be annexed includes property located at 1110 Maplewood Road. That's north of I-270, east of Parsons Avenue, south of Williams Road, and west of Groveport Road. Petition was filed by Agent Thomas Bleedorn on behalf of Pine South Properties. He is in attendance if you have any questions. 18.2% of the site's perimeter is contiguous with the City of Columbus, and the City passed Ordinance Number 0454-2017 on February 27, 2017, indicating services that will be provided once the annexation is approved, in a statement about incompatible land uses and a zoning buffer. Petition meets all statutory requirements of Section 709.021 of the Ohio Revised Code, and pending any questions, we request your approval.
Yeah, I can't remember. Does when you're doing annexation, does the property have to be contiguous?
Mm-hmm. Yes.
It does. Okay, I can remember. Okay, thank you. If there are no comments or questions, move for passage of 189-17.
Sir.
Moved and seconded voting. Commissioner Boyce?
Yes.
Commissioner O'Grady?
Yes.
Resolution number 189-17 has been adopted. Resolution number 190-17, review of petition to annex 0.697 acres from Sharon Township to the City of Columbus, case number ANX-03-17.
This resolution is another expedited Type 2 annexation petition of 0.697 acres from Sharon Township to the City of Columbus. The area to be annexed includes property located at 1859 Snoffer Road, which is south of Snoffer, east of Linworth, and west of State Route 315. Petition was filed on behalf of agent and attorney Christopher Kessler of Plank Law Firm on behalf of the property owners Frank and Miranda Quintana. Mr. Kessler is in attendance if you have any questions. 100% of the site's perimeter is contiguous to the City of Columbus, and the City passed Ordinance Number 0450-2017 on February 27, 2017, indicating the services will be provided, and also a statement regarding possible incompatible land uses in the zoning buffer. This petition meets all the statutory requirements of Ohio Revised Code 709.021, and pending any questions, we request your approval of this resolution.
If there are no comments or questions, move past 190-17.
Second.
Moved and seconded voting. Commissioner Boyce?
Yes.
Commissioner O'Grady?
Yes.
Resolution number 190-17 has been adopted. Resolution number 191-17, review of petition to annex 2.355 acres from Franklin Township to the City of Columbus, case number ANX-04-17.
Again, this resolution is to consider an expedited Type 2 annexation petition of 2.355 acres from Franklin Township to the City of Columbus. The area to be annexed includes property located at 2154 Gantz Road. That's south of Frank, east of Harrisburg Pike, north of I-270, and west of Interstate 71. Petition was filed by agent and attorney Grant Wolf on behalf of property owners Jason Waltke and Stephanie Coe. 55% of the site's perimeter is contiguous with Columbus, and the city passed ordinance number 0455-2017 on February 27, 2017, indicating the services that would be provided and also a statement regarding incompatible land uses and a zoning buffer. Petition meets all statutory requirements of 709.021 of the Ohio Revised Code, and pending any questions, we request your approval.
Move for passage of 191-17.
Second.
Moved and second in voting. Commissioner Boyce?
Yes.
Commissioner O'Grady?
Yes.
Resolution number 191-17 has been adopted.
Thank you.
Thanks, Jenny. Homeland Security and Justice Program.
Resolution number 192-17. Resolution authorizing receipt of the Franklin County FY 2016 Stop Violence Against Women Act Block and Administrative Grant Awards in the amount of $578,764.02.
Good morning, Commissioners. Melissa Pearson, Deputy Director with the Franklin County Homeland Security and Justice Programs. The Violence Against Women Act Block Award is a federal formula grant awarded through the Office on Violence Against Women, passed through the Ohio Office of Criminal Justice Services, down through to Franklin County. It supports enhanced law enforcement, prosecution, and victim services to victims of domestic violence, dating violence, sexual assault, and stalking. Acceptance of the block award in the amount of $561,655.33 and the administrative award in the amount of $17,108.69 does require a 25% match against the admin award, in which totals $5,702.90. Overall, the FY16 VAWA block award reflects a 6% increase over the FY2015 award, which we're happy about. Pending any questions, we respectfully request your approval of this resolution, which accepts the FY16 VAWA block and admin awards.
Good. If there are no comments or questions, move for passage of 192-17.
Second.
Moved and seconded voting. Commissioner Boyce?
Yes.
Commissioner O'Grady?
Yes.
Resolution number 192-17 has been adopted. Resolution number 193-17, resolution authorizing sub-grant awards and contracts for services to provide victim services and enhance law enforcement and prosecution under the FY 2016 Stop Violence Against Women Act Block Grant in the amount of $361,403.16.
Commissioners, in follow-up to the last resolution, which accepted the FY16 VAWA block, we are requesting your approval of 10 sub-grant awards totaling $361,403.16 to support enhanced services for victims of domestic violence, dating violence, stalking, and sexual assault. The 10 projects before you reflect are all continuation projects, and all have a history of meeting or exceeding their performance outcomes. Two of the projects will support law enforcement projects through the Franklin County Sheriff's Office. Two will support prosecution and court efforts for advocacy. And five will support victim service programs, specifically working with underserved and victim service populations. Those five projects will be funded through Choices, Buckeye Ranch, Ohio Hispanic Coalition, Ethiopian Tahawato Social Services, and Ohio Health, also known as SARNCO. Additionally, a training grant in the amount of $4,200 has been suggested so that we can provide training to all individuals out of the prosecution, courts, and victim service programs. Pending any questions, we respectfully request your approval of 10 of these sub-grant awards.
If there are no comments or questions, move for passage of 193-17.
Second.
Moved and seconded in voting. Commissioner Boyce?
Yes.
Commissioner O'Grady?
Yes.
Resolution number 193-17 has been adopted.
Thanks, Commissioners.
Thanks, Melissa. Community partnerships.
Resolution number 194-17, resolution authorizing a one-year collaboration agreement with the Franklin County Public Health Commissioner to administer contracts for health care services for low-income, underinsured, and uninsured county residents.
Good morning, Commissioners. Dana McCrary, Community Partnerships Coordinator with the Office of Management and Budget. We respectfully request approval of this resolution, which will authorize us to enter into a contract with Franklin County Public Health that will subsequently allow us to enter into contract with health-serving organizations, Cancer Support Community of Central Ohio, Central Ohio Diabetes Association, Charitable Pharmacy of Central Ohio, Heart of Ohio Health Center, Physicians Care Connection, and Primary One Healthcare. And those contracts are forthcoming. Right. So pending any questions, we would respectfully request that the resolution be passed.
If there are no comments or questions, move for passage of 194-17.
Second.
Moved and second and voting. Commissioner Boyce?
Yes.
Commissioner O'Grady?
Yes.
Resolution number 194-17 has been adopted.
Thank you.
Thanks, Dana. Human Resources.
Resolution number 195-17, resolution authorizing the settlement of workers' compensation claims against the county by Sierra Merriweather in the amount of $30,000.
Good morning, Commissioners. Today, for your consideration, we have a settlement in the amount of $30,000 for an employee who was injured on the job. The prosecutor's office has reviewed this and agrees that it is a fair and in the best interest of the county. Pending questions, we request your approval.
If there are no comments or questions, move for passage of 195-17.
Second.
Moved and second and voting. Commissioner Boyce?
Yes.
Commissioner O'Grady?
Yes.
Resolution number 195-17 has been adopted. Resolution number 196-17, resolution approving personnel actions.
Today, for your consideration, we have one new hire and one removal. Pending questions, we request your approval.
If there are no comments or questions, move for passage of 196-17.
Second.
Moved and second and voting. Commissioner Boyce?
Yes.
Commissioner O'Grady?
Yes.
Resolution number 196-17 has been adopted.
Thank you.
Thanks, sir. Purchasing Department.
Resolution number 197-17, resolution approving purchases for various Franklin County agencies in the amount of $2,590,659.70.
Good morning, Commissioners. Carl Cusper, representing the Purchasing Department. The resolution before you requests for approval of 88 purchase orders. These purchase orders have been pre-certified as availability funds by the county auditor. Pending any questions, we recommend their approval.
Move for passage of 196-17.
197.
Did I miss that? I'm sorry, 197-17.
Second.
Yeah. Moved and second and voting. Commissioner Boyce?
Yes.
Commissioner O'Grady?
Yes.
Resolution number 197-17 has been adopted.
Thanks, Carl. Board of Commissioners.
Resolution number 198-17, resolution urging the United States Congress, specifically those members representing the people of Ohio, to oppose any and all attacks on affordable, accessible, and comprehensive health coverage for Americans.
Good morning, Commissioners. Kenneth Wilson, County Administrator. As has been stated by the clerk, this resolution would urge the United States Congress, specifically those representing the people of Ohio, to oppose any and all attacks on affordable, accessible, comprehensive health care coverage for Americans. As we know, proposals that are currently being deliberated could mean in Ohio as many as 750,000 could lose coverage if Medicaid expansion is repealed. Also, the county's children and seniors could also be impacted through cuts to the Children's Health Insurance Program and cuts to Medicare. Healthcare block grants or any type of per capita system for federal funding would be harmful to the residents of Franklin County. It would also impact our mental health services, substance abuse disorder treatment. It would impair the ability of our drug courts, and it would also, of course, have an impact on the population in the county's two jail facilities. Therefore, any efforts to undo the progress that have been made under the Affordable Care Act should ensure that everyone with coverage today should be able to afford and keep their health care going into the future. Pending any questions, I would strongly recommend passage of this resolution.
If there are no comments or questions, move for passage of 198-17.
Second.
Moved and second and voting. Commissioner Boyce?
Yes.
Commissioner O'Grady?
Yes.
Resolution number 198-17 has been adopted.
Antoine, do we have journalizations today?
We have one from SWACO, from a public notice submittal for a contiguous vertical expansion PTI application for the Franklin County Sanitary Landfill in accordance with Ohio Revised Code 3734.05A2D. Solid Waste Authority of Central Ohio is submitting a copy of the public notice for an applicant's meeting related to a permit to install application for the contiguous and vertical expansion of the existing Franklin County Sanitary Landfill. The public notice was published on March 2nd, 2017 in the Columbus Dispatch and the Columbus Post. As required, the public notice is being submitted to you within 5 days of publication. The public notice will be published on March 9th, 2017 in the Communicator News. We will also send you that public notice within 5 days of publication. Please contact me at 614-871-5100 if you have any questions from Todd Marsh, Executive Director.
Thank you. That concludes our business for today. We will see everybody next week. Thanks.